Hi, I'm Sharon Macklis at IDG Communications, here with episode 44 of Do More with R, Make GG Plot Easier with GG Easy, plus a patchwork bonus. GGplot 2 is incredibly powerful and flexible, but it's not always easy to remember how to do some things, especially if you're not a frequent user. How do you change the size of a graph title? How do you remove legend titles? My usual solution is to save RStudio code snippets for tasks that I can never remember. But there's also a package that can help, GG Easy. Like the name says, the goal of GG Easy is to, well, make ggplot easy, or at least easier. It has what you may find to be more intuitive functions for some common tasks, mostly around text and axis formatting. Not if you want to change the way lines or points behave or look. All GG Easy functions start with easy underscore, so it's, well, easy to find them using RStudio autocomplete. So let's take a look. If you don't have it on your system yet, GG Easy is now on CRAN, so you can install it with install.packages. For this demo, I'm going to use data about what's on most people's minds these days, coronavirus, as well as loading dplyr, ggplot2, of course, GG Easy, and I'm also going to be using Rio to import data and Lubridate to format one of the columns. You can download data by state from the Coronavirus Tracking Project at covidtracking.com. I'm going to do that. And then I'll import the data with Rio. Let's take a look. You can see the date column came in as an integer, not a date. So I'm just going to use Lubridate, the YMD, which is year, month, date function, to change that column into date objects. Finally, I'm going to filter this data for Louisiana to see the rise in cases there. There's been speculation that Mardi Gras in February might have caused a cluster in New Orleans a bit later. I'll also include data for Massachusetts, a state with about 50% more people, for comparison. Let's do that and switch to my next tab, where I'm going to make a basic ggplot line graph of the data. You should be able to see this in the bottom right panel. Both states are seeing a pretty steep increase. Some of that may be due to an increase in testing. Maybe we just know about more cases because testing ramped up. We'll look at that in a minute. For now, though, how about tweaking this graph? So let's say I'd like to make the graph title larger. With GG Easy, I'll look for easy underscore and scroll until I find what I want. So let's do that. Easy underscore, and I'll start scrolling. Ah, easy plot title size. I'll make that 16-point type and look carefully in the bottom right to see if you can see the headline increase when I run the code. Should be a little larger. If I'd like to rotate the x-axis text, I can do that with an easy rotate. Let's take a look for that. Easy underscore rotate. Easy rotate x labels. I'll put 90 degrees for the rotation. Take a look at the labels at the bottom right here as I run the code. And you can see they've rotated. And I can remove the legend title. It's pretty obvious that these are states. Let's take another look. Easy underscore remove legend title. And now the state header here is gone. Next, I'd like to take a look at the negative coronavirus test results to see if they're rising at similar rates to positives. That may help a bit to see how much of this might be related to more tests. But first, let me store this graph in a variable called positives. Do that. And run the code so that's saved. Next, I'll run the same code as for the first graph, but on the negatives column, which you see here. It looks like some of the increase in Massachusetts cases, the blue line, may be because testing ramped up. There are a lot more negatives, too. But there seems to be a much bigger rise in positives than negatives in Louisiana, although we don't know if that's because testing criteria changed or something else. In any case, it sure would be helpful to see these two graphs side by side. That's where the patchwork package comes in. Let me save this graph in a variable called negatives. If you don't have patchwork, you can install that with install packages also. Now let's see what happens if I load patchwork and then just type the name of the first graph, positives, plus the name of the second graph, negatives. Just like that, I can see side-by-side graphs. Pretty useful for some quick and easy data exploration. I can now use GGEasy to remove one of the two legends so there aren't two on the side-by-side graphs. Easy remove legend from the negatives, and now redraw that. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at bit.ly/do more with R, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on the YouTube IDG Tech Talk channel, where you can subscribe so you'll never miss an episode. Hope to see you next time. And stay healthy and safe, everyone.